Well, I was raving about the Royals' quick start earlier today with a buddy who goes, whoa, 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 whoa. This team has played a grand total of 3 games. And remember, these are the Kansas City Royals, 17 losing seasons in the last 18 years. I have been accused of being a skeptic, but you know what? I really want to buy in the worst way. You go into Anaheim, you take 2 out of 3 against one of the best starting rotations in baseball. Kind of gets your attention, huh? Not to mention the Angels' $155 million payroll, which, by the way, is 3 times larger than the Royals. Not to mention the Angels had the best hitter in baseball in Albert Pujols. And keep in mind, the Angels are built to win and to win now. The Royals displayed some power over the weekend, but the top 4 in the batting order still went a combined 9 for 50 in this 3-game series. Alex Gordon, leadoff man, 0 for 13, 6 strikeouts. Royals won 2 out of 3 because of their pitching. Dayton Moore loves to tell us pitching is the currency of baseball. Can you imagine how scary good this team can become with 3 pitchers posting double-digit victories? They have a trio right now, I believe, barring injury, who have a legitimate shot of doing that. And how about Jonathan Broxton, the lumberjack of a man, blowing away 3 Angels on strikes in his first appearance as the team closer. This guy is a beast. He weighs 300 pounds. And oh yes, the bottom of the Royals order, in which many, including myself, thought would be the Achilles heel. 7, 8, 9 hitters are combined 10 for 30. They're batting 300, folks. That's pretty darn good. I find myself becoming giddy over this team. I should probably back off, but I don't want to because I really like what I see. It's been 27 years since the Royals have been in the playoffs. 27 years. Imagine that. We used to say it was okay to dream a little. We don't have to do that now. We've got the real thing. The only question, how real is it? That's Jack Smack.